Okay. Pull up everything I need. Plus, if I know Pi++ is showing, let's go ahead and see what I want to do. Put my phone down. Oops, somebody added me on. Oh, sorry, somebody's asking me stuff on Discord real quick. Okay, yeah, whatever. I'll answer him after stream. First I need to... Okay, so I need to power down the enchantment, and I need to adjust the weapon list. I do not like the way this is structured, so I'm gonna restructure it, I think. Yes. Probably be a weighted structure rather than a rand list. I hate rand lists like this. They're so ugly. They're nice and simple, but like anybody can do this, but they're so ugly. Yeah, the you could never should never get this number, but okay. Okay. That art should even bother. I'm not gonna change it that much. Think about adding the bad ones. Oh wait, there's a mistake in my doc I posted on Discord. Yeah, there's a mistake on the suggestions I posted on Discord. 1 second. Fix that real quick. Suggestions, Molygo enchanting, edit. Wait, is it? Oh, no, it is correct, okay. Yeah, it's A and E, or E and D. Let me go ahead and open a new doc real quick. These are the actual enchantments and what tier you can use them. It's really weird. There's a bunch of like E and D tier, and then there's a bunch of S, A, and S tier, but there's no like middle ground tiers. I suppose that means you could go for E if you want a defensive tier on your weapon. That'd be one way of doing it. Let me go ahead and yeah, I definitely wanna. Okay, let's see. So we need to create a list of items and weights. So dot elist dot eweight. These are functionally the same thing as set array. I know I don't have to use set array, I always prefer set array though. Bum, 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 bum. And then this will give me more flexibility with see, this is 100, 100, 100, 50, 50, 25, 25, 25, 3. Wait. 26, 27. Yeah. So 2. Sorry. 2, 26, 27, and 2. So that's going to be the wait list for E. I don't probably don't even need to put this in an array. I could probably do a dynamic way of doing it. Oh wait, I did that one twice. Let's see, 100, 100. 8 to 1, 100. 9, 5 is 50. 50, 50. Oh, there's 350, so okay, my bad. I need to be 50, okay. So these are the same official numbers. And then we need to convert this into a weighted array using a function. So let's write that function real quick. For dot at I equals 0, dot at I is less than get array size elist oh my god, and weight, so it's got to be less than both of them, and then dot add I plus plus. Okay, there we go, and then we need to create a for loop. I'm going to be doing this rather than do it on the randomness. I'm going to do it on the initiation, so of the script, so you don't have to fucking do this multiple times. So it won't actually increase performance, decrease performance at all. Okay, and then we need a actual list. So an actual list would be the list. Wait, no, no. We're gonna rename this one the item. List bum 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 what's the function I need? I need the set array function, or the copy array function, right? Fill array, something like that. No, wrong folder. Import doc. My brain, I can't remember the function name. Script command. Here somewhere, get element array. No, that's not what I need. I need array. Yeah, this one I want, clear array. It needs to be get array size elist that, and then this would be dot at I. Okay, and now it should generate. Now it should auto generate this list with weight. And then for this, instead of doing this, you can just do. Set enchant, and this would, instead of using the number here, you would do rand like that. Let me go ahead and disable this right here. Obviously, I want the original. Though I technically don't need it because I have another file, so I don't need to copy this actually. Delete that. It's just taking up space. There we go. Okay. And then I just need to do this for all the arrays. I could technically do it once, because I could use set D and get D instead of this, but I don't like using set D and get D if I can't. It's not completely necessary. D weight. Open a new tab, open your doc real quick. Okay, H dot E dot C. Copy. Oops. Didn't mean to replace all, but B. A. And B for S. I don't know why I copied it so many times, but I did. There we go. Got this. Paste that here. There we go. Now it automatically does it for all the arrays. Close this. No, don't save. Okay. Now let's go ahead and finish in generating. Let's see. Don't touch. Put a note there, and this would be. Oh, I know I need that still. So go ahead and grab it. Grab all of this. And move it down the fuck here. Bottom. And this would be on init. This right here would actually be at the very bottom. Because that didn't get tested at all. Is that the code's already done? This might actually be backspaced once as well. I think. There's multiple S tiers, okay. I mean, there's multiple A, multiple S tiers. So D. D. C. C. B. B. AC, AL, and AS, S, L, C, and SC, SL, and SS, SS. SL and SC. Okay. Okay. S. 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 Let's see. Another array again. Open another document real quick. New document again. Let's see. AS. That's all. Discord. I should probably read, once I finish this a little bit, I'm gonna read Null's thing on Star Gladiator. .sl. There we go. Good. Okay. Close this. I'll leave that open. Okay. Now we need to convert this again into one of these lists. Let's see, D items and D weights. Ah, the weights are wrong though. Okay, 100, 100, 100, 50, 50, 50, 25, 25, 25, 2, 2, 2, 2. Okay. The weights are the same, that makes that easier, okay. Actually, before I do this, I should probably actually design my own choices of bonuses. I mean, it's easy to edit, but... So we have... Pull up the enchantment list real quick. There it is. So obviously we have the magic defense ones, and the HP ones. HP only goes up to 500. Ugh. That's rough. Yeah, the HP is pretty much nobody's gonna want. Does anybody actually... I'm sure I want to handle this. I need to redo the actual enchantment list. I'll just continue with this. So the thing I want to do is I want to remove the plus 5 and plus 6 out of the air. There's no reason why in pre-renewal we should have plus 5 or plus 6. It's all stats. Sticks. This should probably drop down to plus 4. The first two tiers are probably fine. This tier is probably fine. B grade is probably also fine. This, I would probably just remove this one. Spell 5 is also fine. Spell 5 is... it's 3 on cast time, 9% cast time, and like 18 magic attack. Yeah, that's fine. That's 2% magic attack. Yeah, I think the only one that needs to be removed are the plus 5 and plus 6 stat sticks. I'll have S be a higher probability. And then we should probably add in defense and magic defense into more of these trees, which are these ones right here. Maybe go like E. Yeah, maybe I'll just add these to like all the basic ones. Because that's 3 defense and 2 magic defense. So we're plus 6, plus 4, if you get 2 of them. To all the tiers from up to B, and then A tier, I can go plus 4, plus 3, I think it is. Plus 4 and plus 6. Ooh, I don't know about that one. That's a lot of plus 12 defense is a lot. But you're giving up your weapon enchantment. So maybe. I can always adjust these values in the rather than right here as well. So I think I'll do that. And then get rid of the plus five and plus six stat boost. Or at least a plus 6. Yeah, that's what, okay. I have a plan. C grade. 20. 40. 50. 30. 710. 701, 731, 711, 100, 50, 25, 25, 25, 1, 2, 2, 2, 2. Okay. Again, all the same rates. That makes that easy. And then we'll delete that. A little bit of code, a little bit of spacing I don't need. I don't need all the spacing either. Okay, and B grade, 100, 100, 150. Yeah, these are the same. Okay, it's all the same until A. So the weighting, at least the weight is fucking easy. Obviously, I'm going to adjust it here in a minute because I'm going to be adding stuff, but... Okay, there we go. That was easy. And this is AC. And this is AC as well. There you go. My fingers keep getting off place. Yeah, my normal like motion is inked. I messed up somewhere. Okay, and 80, 80, 80, 80, 80, 80, 80, 80, 70, 60, 60, it's weird. Yeah, it's fucking 70. 70, 60, 60, 40, 60, 60, 40. Sixty, sixty, forty, forty, ten, twenty, 10, 5. Those numbers are really weird. Yeah, 10, 20, and then 5, 5. Oh, my bad. Huh. And do I want to go to plus 4 or plus 5? Now we have caster done. I should probably remove this one right here. Yeah, the plus 5 intelligence one. I think let's remove int 5. I'll remove int 5 and that should. By removing that. Okay. while I wait for Nil to respond in Discord. L. Coins. Assuming they're all going to be the same distribution, so I don't need to go through and check all those. For consistency's sake, they should be anyways. Might be doing this for nothing based on what Nola just said. Hello, PLV. Sorry, I had a Discord open and full screened on my second monitor. Yeah, not in full screen it real quick. How are you today? Hello, Dodo. How are you today? How goes your dino game? Oh, thank you, thank you. Awesome. Okay, let's go ahead and grab this. Tab, tank. Tank, and then. And three. That sucks. Okay, let's see. Just gonna get rid of this. And 11 people. yeah, that's pretty bad. Rip. It's like Dino Park or something like that, right? That you're playing? Or the Jurassic World Park thing? Okay. 80, 80, 80. 70, 60, 60. Yeah, 40, 10. 5, 5, okay. Yeah, it's exact same numbers. Mine's a 40, it looks like. Let's see, 80, 80, 80. 70, 60, 60, 40, 40, 10, 10. Yeah, I knew you were in the 40s, okay. There we go. Parkasaurus, yeah, I wasn't sure which one he was playing. Rip. See, this is SC, this is SC now. Okay. I saw it on Steam. I also saw Evo on Steam. For some reason, a bunch of dinosaur games were popping up on my Steam list. Might go to make some more tea in a second. Yeah, that's spicy. It's going to be SL instead of SC. That sounds rough. Short-ranged SS and SS. The only game I played recently was Last Spell. Because Sleepy recommended it to me. Back tab. I mean, no, they're animals. Of course they don't know. Yeah, sounds like a mess. No, that's fine. I know of both games. Dino Garar. Yeah, I'm restructuring the way it's coded. I didn't like it. So, this is now, it dynamically creates a weighted arrays. I've removed. Go ahead and add these to this. Okay. I think I'm only going to add the defensive option to short ranged. For 8 here. And this would be. There's plus 1 on each of them, okay. So 7 and 2. Hey. People are food, not friends. That sounds like fun. Okay, Null suggested removing Blackwing, Gungnir, Bloody Roar, Infiltrator, Tau, Thorn Staff, Destruction Staff, and Death Note. Enchantment list. So let me go ahead and disable those. So Blackwing is a dagger. Blackwing. That's fair. Bloody Roar and Infiltrator. Bloody Roar and Infiltrator. Tau and Gungnir for spears. Gungnir. Actually, those are both Gungnirs. I'll remove only the more card one. And then we have Tailgu, or however you fucking say that. Oh, is that a. Oh, there it is. Okay. Yeah, it's a two-handed sword. Thorn staff. Oh damn! How long is it, are they expected to live for? Maybe that people die. It is good for him. Destructive rod definitely needs to be removed. Death note definitely needs to be removed. Oh, excuse me. Test you with just a little tiny bit of a sriracha powder on it. Okay. Okay, I need to go double check all these items real quick. Make sure they are. I need to check the restrictions on them. These don't have any restrictions. Okay, I'll just remove all restrictions from them. Okay. 1198. I'm next. False, 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 false. And then $11.98, $14.89. Why is that the only one that had trade restrictions? I'm confused. 16 or 13.68, sorry. Yeah, that's the only one that had trade restrictions. Like hard coded onto them. That's weird. To have S grade have defense option as well, or yeah, although S grade have defense option as well. Start the client real quick. Yeah, start client. High Notepad plus plus. Let's go ahead and grab the Enchanter's NPC ID. And reload NPC. There we go. Oh, I'm not wearing it. Marlin. Where's... Why can't I not wear this one? Oh, level requirement probably. Let me go double check, make sure. $14.89. Min level 50. Swordsman, Spearman, true, true. Oh, is it trans only? Might be trans only. Job, Lord, Knight. Okay, yeah, probably trans only. Enchant. Sea God. Defense plus 6. Plus 6 defense on a spear. That is nasty. That item dinged. Enchant, S grade.
magic defense plus 4, okay. No, why I only got the the first two options. This bottom. SS, SL, SC. AS, AL, AC, B, C, and D. Okay. Save. Okay, let's go ahead and reload the NPC again. Add item, 1198. Short range. Continue. Oh, wait. Yeah, okay, that's correct. What did I get this time? Fighting Spirit 7, but yeah, that's correct. Just happened to get, Fighting, Sharp, and Agility. Add all steps. Brutal. Okay. Interesting. Now, do I want to have restrict these to 2 enchantments or 3 enchantments for the unique Malagdo items? I think 3 would be more interesting.
I think I might grab myself some more tea, yeah. I'll be right back, I'm gonna put on some water. Okay, I'm back. Coding. There we go. I think I'll actually do what Null just, or Please just suggested. Remove all the items that are not the fish.
We can always add them as we go. No fish guitar. There's two fish bows. No fish axe. Doom Slayer. Spears. Let's see. Remove all but the Marlin. Just remove all staffs, all two-handed staffs. We'll probably definitely add some more, add some staffs right away. Knuckles. Bows. Musical instruments. And whips. See, there is a sword, a dagger, a spear, a mace, and two bows. Yeah, that's everything. Save. Cancel. Let's go ahead and reload the NPC again. I think I'll start with two enchantments on these. I can always add more. At a later date, I can always increase it, since it's just a function. We'll go ahead and make that a two. And the rest are already two, yeah. Delete all my bottoms. I'm really surprised that code worked first try. Like, genuinely, the entire code just fucking worked. Let's go. Granted, it's pretty simple, but that's beside the point. Okay. Let me go ahead and download Null's Star Gladiator talk real quick. Okay, there we go. Downloaded Star Gladiator Talk. What else do I need to do in... in this area? Anybody think of anything I need to do still? All most of the shops are there. I've disabled two of the vending machines. The quests are enabled. You no longer need the Sea Gods thing. I also got rid of the D. Carter thing because we already have that. What else? I need a shave. My mustache is just slightly touching my lip and it's driving me insane right now. Okay, while I wait for a response from you guys, let me go ahead and read his later changes. HP to rogue levels? Maybe. What's their current HP pool? Let me pull it up. I think I've already buffed their HP pool, so I think he's, making a moot point right there. Import job. Ah, they're on Hunter, Sniper, Rogue. Yeah. No, are you here or no? Or if not, I'm gonna ping you on Discord. Thank you. Everything's already saved. Like, literally, there's no files to save. This file right here is trash file. It's a temporary file. I can delete that. Okay. So, Starglider already has Rogue's HP. Just an FYI. First line. Yeah. Starglider and Rogue are in the same bit of code. I think I already did. I did that a while back. Yeah, that's fair. I think they used to be lower. I think it was one of those one of the things I did when I was doing the bulk changes to classes and condensing the script this bit down. For comparison, they have 4739 blacksmith. Yeah, they have 200 less HP than Blacksmith before the 2.5 multiplier. So 500 less HP than Blacksmith at max level. No, I'm not trolling. Yeah, they have the same HP as Ninja. Okay, let's continue the going down. Class must be simple, complex, yep. Stances and combo is cake. Grant stance based on level. They feel the alignment for the special body depending on the level learned. That would be annoying, that receiving a message every time you change map, but... And is it level learned instead of... It's not level... What? Oh, sorry. Idaro. Yeah, no, fine. I'm adjusting right now. Okay, so feelings. Grant stance based on its level. Additionally, alignment slash blood depending on level learned. Well, you're going to learn level 3. There's no reason why you wouldn't learn level 3. So it wouldn't be level learned. It'd be level active? I'm assuming that's what that's supposed to mean. Okay. Yeah, sentence. Okay. I was assuming, but that's what was confusion. Whenever Circulator logs in, moves mass, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, no. Guide the powerful warmth of the sun. Do a sideways shin kick. Relax the muscles. Target. Lower attack by 20 for 6 seconds. 20%. Okay. Target takes 20% damage increase damage from your current warm wind element. That's fine. Because this will help with party play as well. Jet of flame. Lingering, dealing 100 attack to all enemies around you and 3 times every 0.1 second for 4 seconds. That's 4,000% damage, no? Okay. Yeah, that's going to be a no on 4,000% damage on a... on top of the 1,200%. Consumes 1 SP per hit. Is that current heat? I mean, they don't have a ton of attack. Oh, whatever, I'll leave it. Yeah. Lunar enables lunar combo. First kick upon entering the stance leeches 10% of the target's max HP. By releeching. Okay, what do you mean by leech? Do you mean deals 10% of the target's max HP as damage? Do you mean lowers their max HP by 10%? Or do you mean does it restore your HP? Does it. Wait, which of those? Hunter fly. I don't know. Just clearing. Yeah. Okay. I just wanted to be sure. And that's the first kick. Deals double damage for pressure for 5 seconds. So every 5 seconds, this activates, or you have only your first kick if you use it within 5 seconds. I.e. you enable the stance again. Okay, that's what I thought. Okay. Probably fine. APM slow and thing. Increase your movement speed and APM. Okay, those are inverts of each other. Self buff, self thing. Raise the cold and light. Drop kick, one place. So 5x5 AoE. Yeah, it can probably be lowered down to like 5%. But since it's a 100% chance of doing it. But it is only one hit, but since it can apply on AoE, that means you can basically AoE lifesteal. All you have to do is last 5 seconds, and your next burst will kill you at a bunch. I don't know. 10% is probably fine.
That might be slightly too high. Actually play with that one. I'll leave it as it is. Especially considering it'll be affected by healing power. And if you use buffs, you have heal power bonus. Pain to retaliate, fall of anger. Triple damage, so it is 2700% if you're low HP. What are the HP thresholds on this? Is that, I'm assuming, 25, every 25% missing HP? Yeah, it doubles. So 75%, 50%? No. Probably 33%. Okay. So it's actually not triple damage, because you can't have 0%. Oh, you can't have 0% HP. Never mind. Scratch that. Okay, if you have under 1%, because it rounds down. Yeah, so it's fine. Your first kick upon entering this stance is unavoidable. It does not get reflected. That's perfectly fine. Is around you reach. So just flying sidekick? I'm confused about Warmth of the Stars. Okay. Fair. Also, I'm noticing you're keeping their SP cost incredibly low still. As Warmth of the Star fades into the heat slime. Wait, what? As the Warmth of the Stars falls into the heat slime, follow up Warmth of the Stars with an upward kick. That's fair. Okay. Yeah, I'm very confused about this. Is this remove stuns and slows and snares? That's what I'm reading it as, but it could definitely be reward better. Not slows. Okay, just snares. That's fine then, yeah. I'm not familiar with D&D terminology. I don't play a lot of D&D. I have played a lot of games based on D&D, Final Fantasy, fucking all the, like, Divinity, stuff like that, but I don't actually play D&D, so. Restraining movement is not just Quagmire to be considering restraining your movement, as far as I'm concerned. Slated stars and friends to fall with anger of stars and the downward kick, falling stars, strikes, then damage for an equal to 400% attack for the next 4 seconds. Using a kick skill causes a star to fall. This just buffs the other next following kicks. And I'm assuming this stopped right here is a snare as well. This is for 1.5 seconds. Reactive, defensive, / offensive skills. NPC stop, yeah. Snare. NPC stop is literally a snare. It's the same exact code as ankle snare even. It's fair. But it's
They're not just Angle Snare. There's also there's other ones as well.
Let's see, Sergeant Aurora. Where was I? Oh yeah, defensive, reactive, and defensive specialist bodies. On you grant you their blessing. Whenever you use the skill. What are the blessings? I'm assuming that's read later. Yeah, I'm aware, but when entering a stance, you gain fortune whenever you use a kick, up to skill level stacks of each type, rain for 1 minute, and they're not lost. But what is the actual effect of the celestial fortune for each? Basically a resource. Okay. And you have 7 of each type. Okay, fair. Please, oh, 2 seconds to the source. Is this similar to everybody? Yeah, I'm not going to do AoE Reflect most likely. This is just Reflect Damage. It's split Reflect Damage. It's the Royal Guard skill. You want to split though? So it's closer to a... What's the name of the fucking... One second. The rogue skill, counterattack, or is that a knight skill? The counter one, the one that actually does damage. It blocks attack and does reject sword. I think that maybe the one that blocks damage. I'm trying to remember if it's reject sword or if it's counter strike. Deathbound, yeah, which is the trance rogue guard skill. I don't think that fits them. The Royal Guard version doesn't fit them. I can probably get it to work in a cleaner fashion. Yeah, what I was thinking was basically what you're doing, but make it a skill rather than a reflect. So, get hit by the damage, absorb the damage, and then use that damage on the next skill. And then hit the target back with an AoE skill, which is essentially Reflect, but it would benefit from skill modifiers. So the numbers could be significantly lower for the actual Reflect damage, but you could percent damage modify it with cards and stuff like that. The last beat background music. Was Believe in Myself. It's from Ragnarok Online. Yep. I forget the idea. So I can look at the song ID if you want. It is song 51 from Ragnarok Online. Not on next hit. I didn't say on next hit. Yeah, I usually listen to like other music when I'm coding by myself,
But whenever I'm doing RO streams, I listen to the RO soundtrack. Mostly because I don't get fucking copyright strike, even though I still get copyright strike from RO songs from other people. The most notorious one is White Christmas. I this last Christmas, I got copyright strike from White Christmas from a recover of the original song that was done in like 2017. The RO version of the song came out in like 2004. Or 2002, I forget which. It was like 17-year difference. I'm like, no, fuck you. Anyways, no, what else? Not a on next hit skill. Just, it's think. Think the Ronin Fudoshin stance on dodge reflect damage, where it dodges the attack and reflects and does damage back, similar to that, where auto does damage back, similar to that, and then it makes it AoE. But obviously it doesn't be within 2 seconds. Also, it says physical attack, is that ranged or melee only? Fudoshin gives you a the Ronin's dodge pass ability, the 20% dodge chance. It makes you do damage on when you do that, and then restore SP and stun them when you dodge. Okay. I'm just confirming, that's all. That's what I read it as, but I wanted to confirm it wasn't melee only. Yeah, because then you can, because instead of just scaling it off of this original number is at, per, okay, that's 50% reflect plus 20% per stack, you know, 7 stacks. This is 350. No, it does not, but I can do it that. That's what I was thinking about doing with this one. That would make it different. Fudoshin just uses your attack damage because you don't take damage. And then you could also change this to have an attack damage modifier on it rather than just reflect damage. It gives you more flexibility. It would give you more flexibility with the skill as far as tuning levers. Because I think a brain 350, a 500% damage reflect is dumb. That's dumb. Even if it's one ability, fucking, you see someone doing a Zoro strike. Oh, okay. Here's a 500% damage. Have fun. You lose. Yeah. Because Zoro is still physical damage, even though it ignores defense. Huh. Yeah, but 500% is a lot. Like, the most you can get is like 102%, if I remember correctly. If you let every piece of, if you have every piece of gear that gives you reflect officially, it's like 102% or something like that. Yeah, exactly. Just standard Azure Strike or standard Double Strike. Yeah. But that's what I'm saying. It's, you can't survive 5 Azure Strikes, though. Fucking a sniper. Lord forbid a fucking sniper hits you with this. They're just dead. That's the part I don't like. I know that's the point of reflect. I know. But I very much believe that Reflect should not do more damage. Because typically it's a tank stat. Really? How much damage does a sniper do? How much damage does a double strike do? 800%. So you're doing 4,000% of their attack damage to them. Using your resistances. Yeah, I'm going against a player. So you take your resistances and you deal 4,000% of the damage back at them. Or is there a strike or no, double strike? Double strike does 800% over two or 400% twice for 800%. That's only if you're building tank though. If you're going this build, if you go this build, you just, you know, take off your defensive stats as reflect damage. This is pre-re. Go. It is a very, very heavily modded pre-re, though. Yeah. It's somewhere in between the two. It's significantly closer to pre-re, though, in almost in most states. Like, we have custom defense formulas and stuff like that. So, no, we'll have a good idea on how things do. Oh, then when full tank, you take like 5 damage. Assuming they don't have ignoring stats. Yeah, the 500% reflect just doesn't sit right with me. I'll play with the numbers on that and stuff like that. I'll go with it. No. You don't need to really calculate it. You just go into PvP real quick with somebody and have them sharpshoot you or double strike you. And then times that by 5. The number you say is just times it by 5. It'd be fine if it was times 5. Is it if it's reduced again by their distances, times 5 is fine. If it's not, then it's not. But then we have the nightmare to balance between PvP and PvE and some of that. You had too much to drink? What did you drink? Anyways. I will skip this skill for now. That is my knee-jerk reaction to it. Is 500% feels too strong. Okay. Yeah. But the my current thought is, I'm gonna put some notes right here. Do we want to block the damage or actually just take the damage? Did he say anything about blocking that damage, right? Yeah. Take damage. Add damage to SC. Hit target with skill. Doing percent of damage in SC. Skill deals based on by because this part right here is the part I actually really think would be interesting. The damage, I don't just see. And then if we want, we can just have it ignore defensive guards. Ignore. I'd have to check the numbers. One second. It is open file location, dude. Comp battle. No, comp import battle comp. Yeah. Per five. But the reason why I think this would be more interesting is because then you can build offensively. And your offensive stats will boost your reflect damage rather than just being a defensive tool. It gives it more flexibility that way. And then we can just have it ignore our attacker's defensive cards. So it's essentially just reflect damage. It would be reduced by certain things, like, it'd be reduced by, like, assumption, it would be reduced by, blocked by shield, it would be dodgeable, potentially, by cards that dodge, or, effects that dodge. Probably needs to be missed damage. The only thing about this is it wouldn't be affected by a reflect reduction. So Aegis Ruin wouldn't affect it. It wouldn't be nullified by Aegis Ruin or Ninja as well. Oh my. Okay. I'll leave my notes there for now.
Eclipse falls over you, Shedding.
Yeah, that wouldn't affect it if it's not actually reflect. Aegis Ruin, no. There's Aegis Ruin, there's no prisoner, there is Shogun's skills, there is Ninja. That all ignore reflect. Yeah, basically. I would want it to be a counterattack, not an actual reflect. They should probably use both. If you use the attacker's damage and your attack, in my opinion. Somewhere in between the two. So it's viable as a tank stat and viable as an offensive stat. Because remember, these are... Star Gladiators are pretty much tank. They're not a full DPS. I mean, they are a DPS, but they're not also. Yeah, they're more... Their weapon restrictions make it really hard for them to be as good. Significantly better than Taekwondo. Anyways, let's continue. Eclipse. Shattering your shape form from physical harm for 2 seconds. Sheltering your shape from physical harm for 2 seconds. So that's 27, 36% chance to just avoid physical damage. I realized I was trying to read what it does. So, yeah, up to 36% chance to avoid damage. Yeah, that's fine. Also, yeah, sorry, 30%. I don't know where I got 36%, but whatever. Yeah, that's probably fine. Honestly, that could be even stronger. Consider we have That's probably too high, yeah. 30% is probably too low, 60% is probably too high. Maybe like 40% would be a nice sweet spot. That can be adjusted though. That's not super important. So again, heals you for 30% max HP heal, that's very solid. I'm assuming this can be modified by heal power and stuff like that as well. Sorry, glad I used book. Again, book has safeguard. Safeguard gives you heal power. Safeguard gives you... we'll say 15% heal power. Well, it'd be 30% at max. I'm assuming the max, sorry. So 30% max HP. Yeah, that's fair. But that's percent heal from items. Percent heal from skills usually is. Because there's like two of them. But depending on if it can be increased by heal power, I think 30% is fine. If it can't be, it's probably still fine, actually. Yeah, Shogun on kill is one that definitely increased by heal power. Not that they have much heal power in their kit. So for this one, let me skip the song. Turn my music as well. So for this one, it's 7% bonus damage. Am I reading that correctly? Or by skill level, so it would be 35% bonus damage. Sorry. Per kick, per stack? I'm not sure what you mean, like, per kick. Okay. You mean by celestial stacks, because on all the kicks, okay. Yeah, 30, plus 35% bonus damage is fine. Okay, the union is probably fine. I don't really have anything to say on it either way. It's basically just 5 less skill points. Yeah. Yeah, I'm aware. And they're what lets you rotate between all three stances and really go deep into the skill tree. More likely two stances, but... Yeah. Yeah,
those were already what you did them with before. You did that before with them, right? In the last exact post. Your next combo finisher skill will deal 15% more damage for each slash skill fortune you consume. This one might not work. It might need to apply to additional falling stars, or not even the original damage. So the skill doesn't do damage on its own. Yeah, if you the way you described falling stars, it doesn't actually do damage on its own. It just drops 3 stars on you, guaranteed at the trigger. It probably be better just to increase all falling star damage for the duration. It would be kinda, because the way the falling star would be a skill damage, right? Well, damage doesn't change based on which one you're using. It would just call level 1, 2, or 3. Whenever it would just call the skill again whenever you use another kick. So it would technically be the same skill. I could code it as a second skill, but that's... So the initial hit would just be 3 hits of this one, and then every hit afterwards would call the second skill, and that would make it work. But just give them 15% bonus damage. So I would have it affect everything else, including the bonus follow damage. Thank you for the follow. Well, that's for each slash your fortune you consume. So that's actually 7? Or no. That would be 4. Oh, it would be 60% bonus damage. That or... Wait, it's not 60%? Max is 12. Yes. So, okay, so it's not just that type, it's all types. Okay. So in that case, it would be 12 times 15. So like... 180%? Yeah. That or give falling stars some base damage. Maybe. I don't know. I might have to code them separately then. Because tripling the damage of falling stars for the duration would be bad. If it's 15% fit, that's fine, but... Yeah, with 15% bonus damage, I'd say go with it. But if it's 180%, that's almost a triple damage. Okay, I see. Yeah, in that case, yeah, perfectly fine then. Fuck it. I don't even worry about it. Because it would just end on your combo skill, so it wouldn't affect the following stars anyways. So yeah, it's fine. The description and stuff is fine. Okay. Yeah, I completely misunderstood that. I got focused on the falling star part. The Union Celestial Bodies bestows the greatest protection upon you. You gain 5% damage reduction for every star you currently have. Each hit taken consumes a star. Yeah, I can see that. Gain an additional star for each Celestial Fortune stellar stack. When you take damage, retaliate with a flash of heat, dealing damage
to your attacker. This damage increases additively by 30% for each solar flare you have. And the Moonslight Embrace mending your body and recovering HP and SP each time a star is consumed. Run out of stars. And you have 9 stars, right? Yeah, 9 stars. That's a weird level cap. Just saying. Just. Yeah. That just feels odd. Yeah. That or just make it level 3. Yeah, because the benefits. Yeah, the granularity on this is a little steep, but it is a very, very loaded skill also. Okay, that's fair. A bunch of numbers and math and stuff. I don't feel like reading through. How many skill points to get the last skill in each dance? That's what I actually care about. Because we care about this, right? So it's 5, 10, 12. 5, 10, 12. 5, 10, 12. 36. Or 13. I wonder why I said 12 all those times. That's very clearly 13. Yeah, you have 84 points in total, so you need to pull out 14 points. Sorry. 17 points, yeah, 17 points. Yeah, that looks like fine. You have 17 more skill points of 17 more skill points you could learn over what you can actually learn. Because skill point cap, you have 69 skill points. And there's 86 available. It's about where I like it, so. Because this isn't like a class that has like multiple diverging builds. It's they're all the same thing, functionally. Yeah, exactly. You could probably dual stance. I'd probably your best bet is to dual stance. Which two stances you pick obviously affects you. People most likely to pick, going off the general field of stances, people most likely pick the healing one and the offensive one. Yeah, I like the direction better. There's obviously still some things I pointed out, but this is much more approachable, much less overloaded. The only skill that's actually overloaded is this one, but that's like their big skill. That's fine. This one too, but less so. The damage numbers look fine. The only one I'm concerned about is Heat, because Heat was tied to Union before, right? Or if I, am I misremembering that? Recited feeling? Okay. Which feeling was restricted by what you could attack and stuff like that. So it wouldn't always... So yeah. So functionally, yes. Its power could probably still go down a little bit more. Because you've applied it to anything now. Without having to do the prep work of feelings and all that. But the duration going down is less of a thing than the DPS, but it's probably fine because that's a 1000% DPS rate. Basically, it's a free hit every second, which isn't too bad. And it's on their final hit, right? Yeah, Solar Flare. Okay. Yeah, I think the only changes I'm going to do is Halo be closer to counterattack. Like a mixture between counterattack and reflect. Rather than just you reflect a bunch of damage in an AoE. Even if it's split, that's fine. SS is doing 2.8k. So it's doing 2.8k to you, and then 5 times that to the attacker. And what's the prerequisite for casting this? Other than it has a 5 single down? Yes. Yeah, so about 5 seconds. Yeah, I just don't like... I do not like... I don't like AoE Reflect. I think that's a dumb mechanic. Because Lord forbid you get hit by somebody else. You shouldn't... Your teammate should not die because you attack somebody. Obviously for MVPs and stuff like that, for like boss fights, that's fine, but in PvP. I don't think there's any skills in the game that do that. The only exception would be Devotion, but that's not quite the same. Yeah. Yeah, in GVG and stuff like that, yeah. It's we have a lot of HP. Like, fights definitely last longer. And it is only one hit, and it does have a 5-second delay. Although, that part is the only part that makes it even remotely balanced at these numbers. I still think it's boring as well. That's probably the biggest thing. Like, this is interesting. That's really interesting. Fogstars is interesting. Where's the other one? Eclipse, evasion, that's fine. Healing, that's fine. Like, these two are fine. Like, this one's simple, but it's really strong. This one's simple, but it's really strong. And these are both defensive tools. This is not really a defensive tool. Because if you're building defensive, this isn't going to matter. I think it... Here's the numbers. I'm going to drop some... Wrong button. Let me draw some numbers real quick. We'll say... We'll use the same numbers.
for your attack. And then we'll drop these numbers. I'm worried you don't like how your life works. That's the thing, you can ignore resistance with a skill. A skill can just ignore resistances. There are certain resistances you cannot ignore. You can't ignore Safeguard. Safeguard's flat damage reduction. You can't ignore status resistances, so Assumptio. You can't ignore shields. To reflect damage, ignore shields, by the way. So, yeah, and those that's fine. Those are big skills. Refine Resist, I believe, is Fire Resist is calculated somewhere else. It should be ignored. And if not, that matters a little bit more, but because that's passive. Let's see. What's 20 times 7? I might show him. Yeah. What's... What's the there you go, 3 to 3. Yeah. So this is the numbers I'm currently thinking. I mean, go play, have a ninja in your party. Also, I'm curious how, I did not apply to Minute Magic Reflect last patch. I intentionally didn't do it because it was on the physical side of the tree. Wizard can already ignore it, or ignore Magic Defense, or Magic Reflect, so, all woodlinked. And then... I made no prisoners apply as well. I think it's anything classified as in the same group as Kaite. So Magic Mirror, you should also affect Magic Mirror. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it also affects Magic Mirror. If it doesn't, it should. Yeah, I don't think that the option belongs on Ninja. Since that's a physical skill tree perk, there should probably be another option somewhere for Magic Reflect specifically, but I'm not sure where to put it. Yeah, because it's currently the only anti-reflect things are in physical classes mostly. What about Stalker?
I mean, yeah, it could be another rune combo. That's fine. I'd probably want to... That's a fair thing. I'd probably make it a separate, I don't know, Slaughter, you definitely want strength for. Like, Slaughter is so good. 40 strength? Like, that one bribes you guys so hard. I'm going to play with the numbers on this one. I'm not sure what I want. The other question would be, do we block the damage? That's the only other question. If we block the damage, probably not, because it's... Because it would just stack too much with this. Yeah. Okay. Save. Oh yeah, for the enchanting, I went ahead and recoded the enchanting before you guys joined the stream. Furushin, that's what I'm gonna reference that one. Ronin does. But that's like their weakest build. About this. What's this? Sorry. About reworking weapons. What do you mean reworking weapons? Sorry. Oh, definitely. I mean, technically use it without a slot, but they're just overshadowed by so quickly by other things. Oh no. Well, yeah, for now, I have the, Oh, you know, I fully agree, yeah. That's why I was, Yeah, that's one of the reasons why I wanted to remove weapons from it. That's why we were talking about it. That's why the conversation was started. It's because I need to remove a bunch of weapons from it. And I needed to adjust the enchantments. For the actual list of weapons, it's currently just the fish. A lot of these weapons can definitely be used in this. Great Axe, Doomslayer maybe even. Oh, okay. And they do need level 4 weapons because of the way that it's coded. I could make it level 3 weapons as well. But... And another thing I wanted to work on was the suggestion I rejected from Fly a while back because I was messing with him. I wouldn't mind upgraded versions of like bad weapons. That's why I mentioned a while back the improved version of books. Yeah, some more of those would be. The thing is, there's only so much design space for unique effects. No. Thought I had a. I thought I had a socket NPC. But yeah, in making... Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of potential effects that are unique, but well, defense ignore in general is unhealthy, but I understand why it exists. It just makes those items like best. Like, defensive items just have more power than everything else. Oh, yeah. Like, these items are not weak by any means, by the way. 20 crit, 50% crit damage. Crystallization, which... Yeah, that's why if you guys actually used all your defense reduction tools, you wouldn't need defense ignore. Which I think that's fine. I think if it's tools in kits, it's good. If it's tools, I equipped a weapon, okay. I ignore this entire game mechanic. Yeah, exactly. That's fine. You also do stuff like Warcry. Warcry's minus 20 defense. Yeah, I fully agree with that. Like Azura ignoring your defense is fine. But if we'll use a Bloody Roar. It's the best slot. It's the best weapon. Like, hands down against anything in Demi-Human. Wait, PvP or PvE? Oh, they're Demi-Human? Okay, Blood Roar. Infiltrator also, right? Yeah. Durga's really was solid, a solid addition. I think Durga's probably number like three. Though so I don't think it quite competes with Bloody Roar and Infiltrator, but it's pretty close. Katars there's lots of options. But like books. Yeah, books there's not a lot of options. Staff is another one that's got a good options. There's genuinely quite a good staffs. But books, knuckles, axes are fucking awful. Yeah. Oh, that's one of the reasons why I dropped the book suggestion I did in. I was looking for my socket in NPC, that's right. I thought I had a custom socket in NPC. Yeah, that's fair. There's also not a lot of axes, anyways. Like, there's like 50 axes in the game in total, and that's including like, oh, this one has one slot, this one has two slots. And 50 is probably generous. Let me see, read my server. I'm curious. Equipment, weapon, one-handed axes. There is 11. This is 10 per page, right? Or the 12 per page. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Sorry, 12 per page. So it's 13. Yeah, 13 one-handed axes in total. That's everything. 13. There's no way they're going to be competitive. Because the five of them are, like, low tier. Which is one of the reasons why I would like to add more weapons instead of, you know, what was it called? Unfortunately, there's no fish axes. It's only the fish items are. There's two bows, a two-handed spear, two-handed sword, and a dagger. And these are actually probably competitive, by the way. Let me go and pull up all the items for you guys. I don't know if you know them all, so. Okay. You have a good one, sir. Yeah, the spear's probably the worst one in the set. Okay, enjoy. Have fun cooking. Yeah, like, the spear is class-specific. That's why it's terrible, I think. All the other ones are, like, generalistic. Yeah, 50% crit damage. That's also 99. And then 20% range damage. And can be run by rogue. That it has zero weight currently. I'm going to adjust the weights. I was already planning on doing that. They should not weigh zero anymore. They're not rentals. They're just weapons now. Let me go ahead and edit that real quick. Oh wait, I'm not even showing RL. Shit. hide out by close list now. Yeah, so like, these are next level 99, so if you hit next level, you get the bonus. Develop level 4, so you get the fucking level. Holy shit, speaking is hard. 1 second. They are weapon level 4, so you get the weapon level 4 perks from mastery. None of them have any refined. Yeah, spiral. The spear needs. I want to make change the spear completely, anyways. It does have very solid attack damage, but. Compared to. Potentially, yeah. I had less attack damage than Giant Crossbow, though, I'm pretty sure. Sorry, I'm looking at spears right now. Yeah, so Marlin is the highest.